Hello. Hi, Pinaki. Good evening.
Hey, Varun.
Yeah. Okay,
Good
I'm put.
evening.
Yeah,
I'm Hi,
putting.
everyone.
Hello. I'm putting myself on mute. Just a moment.
Are you guys being able to see the screen? Anyone
Yes.
could?
Yes.
Anyone can respond. But are things on my the participant list and all, are those visible like with the screen or only the screen is visible?
Only the screen is visible.
Only the screen is visible.
Okay. और स्क्रीन दे दीजिए मैं वो दे देता हूं हां तो हेल्प करने लगे ना
नो आई एम मूविंग द
स्क्रीन हां
ये पीछे आप को चला तो पीछे आप को देखो नहीं बस तो आने को तब तुम ही दे तो पीछे आप को देखो और देखो कि तुम आपको पीछे ना गंदा फील हो रहा है ओके तुम और को ना तुम जो वीडियो आप को तुम कर को बैठे सब वीडियो
Good evening. Hi all.
Aditya, the screen is visible?
Yes, I can see it. Yes.
Okay. So you just be unmuted. So what I'll do is I will be playing some music and you can just give me feedback whether it is, how do I go back?
Okay. So Pinaki, I'll be leaving early today. I have a client call from 9:30.
You have a call, no? Do a stop share and come back. Yeah, I think. So now nothing is visible. It's like the normal.
Yeah, I can see you, right? Yes.
PM, how are you?
Hi, Ashok. I'm doing good. How are you doing? A little wet and clammy, but that's okay.
Fine.
How are you, Ashok? All well?
Yeah, everything fine.
Good.
Yeah.
Good evening, Ashok.
Good evening. Good evening.
Talk. Hello.
Hi, Joanna. Evening, Ashok.
Good evening, Adit. How are you?
I'm doing good.
Hi, Ranujay.
Hi, Anjan. Happy New Year.
Happy New Year. Thank you. The same to you. Hi, Joya.
Hi, Ranjan.
I sent you a note yesterday. Did you get a chance to look at it?
Yeah, I'll take care of it today.
Okay, great. Thank you. Just get...
evening. Good morning, Ranjan. Good morning, Arvind.
Hi, Swati.
Good morning, Swati. How are you?
Hey, good, Ranjan. Thank you so much, Ranjan.
Oh, you're welcome. Anytime. I had to go not the extra mile, but a few hundred miles to get it done.
I know. Thank you so much.
Virtually, right?
Yeah.
Hi, good morning. Hi, everyone.
Hi. Hi, Jagannath. Good evening.
Good evening. Good evening to everyone. Good morning, Ranjan, Arvind.
Good. Good evening. Good to see you, Sudipta.
Yes.
Hey, Ranjan, good morning. This is Vikas.
Hi, Vikas. Good to see you. Good evening. Happy New Year.
You too.
Hi, Ashok.
Hi, good morning. Good evening, everybody. Hi, guys.
Hi, Ashok. Hi, Ranjan.
How are you?
Hi, how are you?
Hi, how are
Good morning, good evening, everyone. This is Saransh.
Saransh, how are you?
Good, thank you.
Good evening, everyone. Devraj. Hi, Ashok.
Hi, Devraj.
Happy New Year to everyone.
Happy New Year to everyone.
Happy New Year and good evening to everyone.
I think let's put a conditional clause on it. Happy COVID-free New Year.
Hopefully, yes. Yeah. Very and soon.
Means, you know, I'm calling it COVID-free because they won't charge us for the COVID. It's like fat-free. When they give you something, they don't charge you for the fat.
Yeah. I think that the problem is that Moderna will get very upset.
Yeah,
so you are going to put Moderna on out of business.
No, there'll be as long as they're humans, there's some disease. Moderna has about 110 patents pending because he has shown it to me on the board. You know, on the LED display as to what are the patents pending, and the mRNA DNA sequence that they're using is revolutionary, and they've been working on it for a while. It's very interesting.
Hi, everyone. Good morning. Oh, it's good morning for me. Good evening. How are you?
Happy, Vikas.
Happy. How is everyone? Lay down, Lassa. Lord, I could not take my wills.
Grateful Dead, the biggest fan is Pinaki, and we are very grateful we are not dead at this point of time with COVID.
Thank you, Ranjan. So good evening to all of you from the subcontinent and to friends from US. Good morning. On behalf of Inter-IIT Toastmasters, a happy new year and a warm welcome to all of you. Great to see you happen in large numbers. I think the last that I saw, like, we are already 60 plus attendees. Colleagues, club members, and connections from District 41 Toastmasters, thank you for this amazing participation in what is a day of nostalgia for Inter-IIT Toastmasters Club. A special welcome to our guest speakers from the land of Himalayas, Nepal. District 41 Parliamentarian, Distinguished Toastmaster Suman Shakya, and District 41 Speech Champion Alpha Maya Shakya. So thank you, Suman and Alpha, for being with us today. And we are also privileged to have amongst us club patron, founder, president, and CEO of Inter-IIT, Ashok Laha. Let me acknowledge the presence of past and present district officers, Club Growth Director DTM Ankur Yadav, Division D Director DTM Preetish Acharya, Area D1 Director Mansi Kumar, District Editor, Newsletter Editor DTM, Rita Sandhu, Area Director Samita Manocha, Area Director Gagan Jolly, Past District Officer DTM P.U. Sugarwal, Past District Officer DTM Arun Padmanabhan, Past District Officer Abdesh Srivastav. Thank you all for joining the meeting. Sorry if I have missed out the name of any other district officer who has joined in. You could certainly let me know through a private chat for recognition later in the meeting. Let me also acknowledge presence of some of our club alumni. So Abhinav Khanna, Gaurav Singh, Neeti Jain, Varun. Guys, soak in nostalgia. My name is Pinaki and I'm serving as the Zoom host today. Let us all adhere to the meeting guidelines which were on display in the lead up and also shared to the registered participants. I'll very briefly repeat a couple of important ones. First, of course, is to stay on mute unless when it is your scheduled turn to speak. And please ensure that there are no audio distractions in your background, no phone rings. For the Q&A section following the keynote speech by DTM Suman Shakya, please do type your questions using the Zoom chat mechanism. So here we are. It's a moment of reflection, a moment of nostalgia, a moment when I rather not talk of transformation, of change. So here is an ode to my home club. Don't go changing to try and please me. You never let me down before. Don't imagine you're too familiar and I don't see you anymore. I would not leave you in times of trouble. We never could have come this far. I took the good times, we'll take the bad times. I'll take you just the way you are. Well, that was not great. Thank you, Billy Joel, for that. And folks, cheers. Here is a toast to our grand 600. A toast to recognize our charter members who are still with us. Ashok, DTM Swati, Sanjay Kapoor, and yours truly. Among the 31 members who were the charter members at the in 2006. Yes, we are happy just the way we are. And like any other living entity, we too have had a mix of good times, bad times, average times. Let's now see a short slideshow that captures the journey of our club, our good times. Just give me a moment. I'll put it on share. And while I admit a few other people, so I'm happy to say that we have 67 participants. So are you able to see my slide?
Not yet, Pinaki.
Okay.
Now I can see the presentation. Thank you.
Thank you, guys. Let's give ourselves a big hand for this, what's been truly a wonderful journey for us. And let's now move on to the next segment. It's now time for me to call on stage a visionary leader, a master storyteller, my mentor, and our CEO, Ashok, for the patron's address. Please welcome with a big round of virtual applause, Mr. Ashok Laha. Ashok, the stage is yours.
Thanks, Pinaki. Welcome, everybody. And good evening to the people in India, and good morning to the people in US. I'd like to give a thanks to Ranjan. Ranjan, I was talking to Ranjan. Ranjan said we should be Toastmasters Club member. So Ranjan, hopefully you'll be joined the Toastmasters Club. It's an absolute honor and privilege to attend the Toastmasters Club 600th meeting. It's quite a milestone, and I would not be prouder. As you told that we started in 2006, this meeting is significant due to many factors. We are reaching to grow 600 number, and we'll go beyond that, which symbolizes our passion to the best value of communication and leadership. This meeting is going to be a very exciting meeting because we have got two great speakers, Sumon and Alpha. I got a chance to meet Sumon just half an hour before that. Very fine. I'd like to thank very much for their joining to us. We are going to have a Swati there as a TMOD. Swati, I got a chance to know Swati for a long time. Swati is a distinguished DTM, distinguished Toastmaster Club. She also won the national championship some time ago and is one of the keen mentors of our membership club. Okay. You know, I was exposed to the Toastmaster Club by accident. When I was almost like a 24, 25 years old. I was a co-kid. I just went to the US. I finished my grad school. I got a job in one of the largest company, multinational corporations. I was Chicago and I was working there. I got the job as a software programmer. So I was tentative, shy, tense, and not sure about myself, but that's inside me. But outside, I was a coquette, I was a bit arrogant, and I think I can do everything themselves, you know. Based on my experience in India, I grew up here, I thought that just with my great GPA and everything else, I'll get promoted every 2 years. Natural thing to do, right? That's normally people work. You are technically brilliant, you will get promoted. So I found a mentor. One of the guy who's very, very, very well-known guy, respected guy in the company. I like him, he liked me, so I become mentor. So I ask him an obvious question. What will it take to get promoted? What it will take to get promoted? And how fast I can get promoted. That also led to my salary increase and everything, all the stuff, right? And the corner office, and you get promoted, you get a closed office, corner office, that type of stuff. And he told me, he looked at me, told me bluntly, also, you have no chance to get promoted here. Now, when somebody tells you that, you know, you often feel like you're slapping the guy's face. But I listened to him, I said, oh, why? I didn't say anything. Then he told me that, I know your GPA is very good, your records are very good, so is everybody in this town, has a very good record. But your main disadvantage is that your communication skill is very average. You will never get a chance. You will never be able to go and talk with the senior management in the company. You never get a chance to do that. Even you do that, they will laugh at you. They will not talk with you. The promotions here, they have to have a talk with those people that influence them. Then I told him what I can do. He told me that you got two choices. Either you hire a private coach and they can teach you how to communicate, or join Toastmaster Club. Okay? Private coach will be very expensive coach. They probably charge you $50 to $100 an hour at those days. But or you join Toastmaster Club. So I elected a cheaper approach, Toastmaster Club. I used to drive 60 kilometers, 40 miles every day, once a week, to join the find a community Toastmaster Club. There is no corporate Toastmaster Club per se. So I used to go there. Then years later, you know, and I attended every day, Chicago snow, rain, and summer, I used to go there. And then as a result of that fact, we got a chance to meet lots of great people. They become good friends. I still keep in contact with those, some of the guys, you know. The result is that years later, as you move on in my career, I was able to talk with the senior management. And years later, probably 3, 4, 5 years later, I got promoted to a cost center manager. So that helped me quite a lot. Okay. The two pillars of Toastmaster Club, I know there are lots of people in the company around the other clubs also. Why Toastmaster Club? I can speak English very well. I can communicate extremely well. The two pillars of Toastmaster Club are the communication and the leadership. These two go hand to hand. To be an effective leader, great communication skills are must. Particularly in this day, particularly in the year 2021 onwards, if you cannot communicate, communication means you will not be able to move up at all. Unless you go to work for a research lab or Moderna, when you can create a vaccine, then it doesn't matter too much. It helps us to understand others better, gain respect and trust from our colleagues. It sets clear and understandable goal and expectations. Communication, both written and verbal, plays such a vital role in all aspects of our life, whether it's at home or in a social gathering with your friends or in the professional space. The act of communication boils down to transferring information, again, either written or verbally, from one to another. It's an essential life skill, which takes us months or years or even decades to master. The ability to effectively communicate can give us confidence. It helps clear misconceptions, help us to navigate life with relative ease. We started the company in 1997. At that time, software company, the high demand, you know. So we are charging lots of money. There's a huge demand in US. So anything which you can do, if you're a software engineer, you can get a business. You can get a business, there is no question. Dot-com bust in 2001 has changed quite a lot. Completely business changed quite a lot. US become very competitive. All of a sudden, we found ourselves, we are competing with the large companies. And all of a sudden, with the surplus, the business has gone down. Then we started hearing the complaint from the customers. Complaint was that, you are hearing customer complain that the people whom they are talking, our employees who are customer facing. On average, they say that their poor communication skills, average to poor communication skills. They are talking about it, do that. Then I started how to resolve it, you know. So that's 2001. I thought probably that will happen, but it continued. And so then we started exploring how to improve the communication skill. We hired some management consultants, some teach some people here, some classes we gave to them, but that didn't improve too much. Parallelly, I started going to based on my experience in Toastmaster Club, what I did myself, I started going to Toastmaster Club in Delhi, Delhi Community College, Community Club. Then there I met a gentleman, and he's a very accomplished senior member on the club, and he was holding a position there, probably president of the club or something like that. I enticed him to join us as a full-time employee, and he joined us and he started the club. That happened in 2006. That's why we started the club. And we accomplished quite a lot. And Pinaki, his slide, he showed those slides, what you have accomplished so far. You know, you are proud of it, what you have done. Okay. You know, I'm proud of the club and the members in it. Each and every one of you have taken time of your busy schedule to better yourself, to become better in communications and in effect to become future leaders. Almost all of you guys have aspiration to be the leader, to be the CEO of a company. That's the one thing I like to do. I like to see. It's remarkable that see how you have evolved over the period of time. I like to thank the opportunity to the president of the club, Devasish Bhattacharya, and his executive members, Sudipto, Devarun, Sanjay Kapoor, Swati, for their immense contribution. And special thanks to Pinaki for his, he became a charter member, for his dedication, commitment, and contributions since the inception of the club in 2006. Pinaki has done a wonderful job since the club started. I'm also honored to welcome the two esteemed guest speakers from the beautiful country of Nepal, Sumon and Alpha. I got self-interest. I never been to Nepal. I'm hoping that I could build a relationship with those guys. So hopefully someday I may go to Nepal or they invite me. Sumon, I'm waiting for your invitation to go there. So let's kick off the 2021 on a positive note with a wonderful Toastmaster Club meeting. Please join me in welcoming Sumon and Alpha. Over to DTM, Swati Dev. Thank you.
So thank you, Ashok, for that enlightenment through storytelling, and also for encouraging all of us. Friends, let's all virtually applaud Ashok for the wonderful words of wisdom. So the theme for today's meeting is a new beginning. And to drive the meeting forward on this theme, I will now call upon the moderator for today's session, the anchor, someone who is the first inter-IITian to achieve the Distinguished Toastmasters title. He's a past district officer, a past district table topics champion, DTM Swati Dey. But before I ask Swati to assume stage, as requested by her, I would like to talk a few things on timer and timing. So she was a little uncomfortable handling that part. So the timer today is Narendra Rathod. So he will be named as timer_Narendra. And he will be timing the prepared speeches, topics and evaluation, and also the keynotes. So the prepared speeches are as usual. Those are 5 to 7 minutes, including Alpha speech, and with a 30-second grace period. Green card comes up at 5 minutes, yellow card at 6 minutes, and the red card at 7 minutes. So for all the speakers, I would request that you could probably position the timer in such a way, you know, on the Zoom scroll, so that the timer is visible when it is your turn, time to speak. And if you want, you could also pin the timer. So that is your choice. We are not really using the screen share as done in contests or in other places. Problem with that is that relegates the speaker to a corner and you can only see the card. We don't want to do that. So this is one request which I am having of the speakers. For the table topics, the timings are 1 to 2 minutes. So 1 minute green card, 1.5 minutes yellow card, and the red card is at 2 minutes with a grace period of 30 seconds. And for there is only one speech which will be evaluated. Since Alpha speech is a showcase speech, we don't have any evaluator for that. So the evaluator's time is 2 to 3 minutes, 2 minutes green card, 2.5 minutes yellow card, and 3 minutes is the red card. And for the keynote by Suman, we have 20 minutes overall. Timing it in this way. So at 12 minutes, green card. At 15 minutes, yellow card. And at 18 minutes, we have a red card with 2 minutes of grace period. So we have built a bit of buffer in the Q&A section also. And as a viewer, if you would like to see the speaker without any distractions, as you know, it's a 70 plus people who are there. So someone drops in, etc. So it is your choice that you may like to pin any particular speaker which you want to see fully, dedicatedly. So with these words, I would now once again welcome DTM Swati Day to take the meeting forward. So DTM Swati, the stage is all yours.
Thank you, DTM Pinaki. Dip, 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 add the sugar and milk, and it's ready to sip. If you want it stronger, dip a little longer. Dip, 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 and it's ready to sip. Strange how life is just like a cup of tea. The more storms we endure, the stronger we become. There seems to be a sinister divine design, I suspect annual design, behind dipping us into a series of hot tests and hard knocks. Yet, here we all are, rejoicing and celebrating tonight. Friends, as we embark on a nostalgic journey of rejoicing the glorious past and reliving fond memories, an agile team of angels will ensure that we are not too wayward. Please meet the grammarian, Toastmaster Debraj Indra. He will keep an eagle eye on the usage of correct grammar for today. Our counter, Toastmaster Bikram Bal. He will record our usage of filler words. Timer, Toastmaster Narendra Rathore. He will alert us about the passage of time. And last but not least, Parliamentarian Toastmaster Pragya, she will ensure that we are not too naughty today. The agile angels will present their reports when called upon by the general evaluator later tonight. Let's begin the show, friends, with a drum roll for all of those who are present here today with us tonight. And who better to start the drum roll with? But our alumni, those who have done us proud, Inter-IIT Toastmasters Club would not be where we stand today without you guys. Friends, please give it up for Neeti Jain, Abhinav Khanna, and Gaurav Sharma, the Catman. our alumni champions forever. Welcome back home. Moving on, a big thank you to all the district officers, fellow Toastmasters, and friends joining us tonight over Zoom and Facebook Live. We are honored to have you with us tonight. Here's one for our members. Tonight is for all of us. Let's applaud ourselves and resolve to rise and shine better and brighter in the testing times to come. Finally, raising a toast to one man who said, "I have a dream." I have a dream. He had a vision and he planted a tiny seed of a Toastmasters club 15 years ago. He nurtured it with love, care, toil, sweat, and blood. That tiny seed has grown into a mighty banyan tree with roots and branches far and wide. Our mentor, patron, friend, philosopher, and guide, our principal partner in crime, Ashok Laha. Toastmaster Ashok Laha, take a bow. Friends, miles to go before we sleep. Let's rock. Are we ready to rock? She walks in beauty like the night of cloudless climes and starry skies, and all that's best of dark and bright meet in her aspect and her eyes. Lord Byron's lines are apt to sum up our showcase champion speaker tonight, Alpha Maya Shakya, winner of International Speech Contest 2020, District 41, a business graduate, content marketer, a trainer, a poet, a dreamer, and a singer. Toastmasters and friends, I give you Alpha Maya Shakya. Reopen the box. Reopen the box. Alpha Maya Shakya.
Never open the box. Pandora was told when she was sent from heaven to earth. Now you might have heard the story about Pandora's box, about how it was forbidden to be opened, and when Pandora opened it, out came from her box agony, pain, and suffering that was unleashed all over humanity. This is the Greek myth that most of us know about. But did you know that Pandora closed her box just when there was something that was still inside? Presiding officer, my dear friends, you and I, we also carry our own Pandora's box. You have yours and I have mine. And our box holds many things, among them fear. Fear of failure, fear of missing out, fear of not being enough. We might have opened our box and closed it just like Pandora did. I was a little child when I first opened my box. I was in front of 40 new faces, and all I had to do was speak my name. Now, my name, if you've heard the Toastmaster of the day, has only four letters, and it's quite simple. Of course, it's my name. I'm supposed to know it. And still, I couldn't utter a single sound. I closed the box believing I would never be able to speak in front of an audience. The next time I opened the box, I was in bed, my head burning with fever. And in my head, I was also making a long list of things I was going to eat when I get better. I would get better 3 months later. Now, something worse than not being able to eat your favorite snacks for 3 months? Well, having to repeat my university education right from the start, because I had fallen ill 2 days before the final examination and I couldn't appear in even a single one. I watched my peers, my classmates, move one step ahead while I was still behind. I closed the box believing I had missed out. The next time I opened the box, I saw a beautiful black and white piano with its keys. The first time I saw a real piano, I was 3 years old. And the only reason I remember is because I have a photograph. Yep, that is me. Cute, right? Still cute, I guess. The next time I would see a real piano would be 16 years later. But all this time, I kept telling myself that I wouldn't be able to play that instrument. Because you see, it takes two hands to play the piano. One and a half can't do much. I closed the box, believing I was not enough. My dear friends, when was the last time you opened your boxes? Was it in the morning when you looked at the mirror and the box said you're not pretty? Or was it the time when you plucked your heart out and gave it to someone but had it returned and the box said you'll not be happy? Or was it when you watched your dreams crumble in front of your eyes and the box said you're not worthy? You and I, we've both opened our boxes and unleashed pain. And we might have closed it, just like Pandora did. But we've also realized that we cannot deny it, destroy it, or hide it. So, what shall we do of our box? Reopen it. My dear friends, remember Pandora still had something inside her box when she closed it. And so she would go back and she would reopen her box. This time, there would only be a warm sensation that would fill her heart. Pandora had unleashed hope, which was the last thing still inside the box. Our boxes also contains that very hope flickering inside, telling us to try again, to give it another try, to give it another shot. When I reopened my box, I found that same hope inside, telling me to try again. I tried to speak, I failed, and I tried again. From someone who couldn't utter her own name, to winning my first ever speaking award in 12th grade, that due with cash prize. Now, having to restart my university education wasn't great, but along the way, I made friends who were goofy enough to match my terrible dance steps. I also happened to graduate at the top of my class, which was the cherry on top. One day, I went back to the piano, uncovered its sheets, and sat down to learn how to play it, no matter how slow or awkward. And one day, when Yurima's famous River Flows in You flew out of my keys, da 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 da, I knew that I had faced my fears and overcome it by reopening my box. My dear friends, where are your boxes? The big ones, the small ones, the heavy ones, the not so heavy ones, the ones you opened and closed again. Bring them out, for in its depth, there awaits hope, fluttering its wings, telling you to try again, to reclaim your dreams. My dear friends, will you reopen your box? Over to you, Toastmaster of the day.
Thank you, Alpha. What a speech. What a speech. It's been very long since I've ever heard such a heart-touching and a thought-provoking speech.
Thank you so much.
We have so many young Toastmasters out here, aspiring championship winners. And since we have you with us, the championship winner of 2020, would you like to share a few tips with the Toastmasters who are here today?
Great. Thank you so much for having me, first of all. It's wonderful being here at the 600th meeting. About the tips, I think the most important thing is to enjoy the journey, to have fun, to learn, and to soak in the vibe. I think that's really what keeps it going, keeps it alive and new.
Thank you. And another question which we often come up with is, how do we choose a speech topic? Suppose we are preparing for the championship and there are so many themes we like to speak about. How do we choose the speech topic? How did you choose the speech topic for your championship speech?
Thank you so much for the question. Yes, true. Speech topic is something that is appears for the first, you know, it comes before your speech because it's announced before, and it might have some role to play in the contest or even in general speeches that we give at Toastmasters. And it is indeed sometimes a tricky situation to choose. I would usually choose a speech topic is I would try to find a common thread, something that ties together the entire speech, something that is sometimes it's obvious, sometimes it's not so obvious. So my speech Reopen the Box was based on the box and how reopening it, how Pandora reopens it, and how I also reopened it. So that's based on the theme that flows through it. So usually that's what I try to do. I try to find a common theme which stands true for the entire part of the speech and, you know, kind of holds it together.
Wow, you put it so well. And I also notice, Alpha, that there's so much of music in you, and music has played such an important part in your life. You're a pianist, you play the ukulele, and would you like to hum a few lines for us today?
Sure, I'll also get my ukulele. It's here. So I would like to hum Hey Jude.
Ah, the Beatles, yes, let's have it.
The Beatles, I guess a lot of us here know the song, so please do hum along wherever you are and enjoy a few lines. Hey Jude, don't make it bad. Take a sad song and make it better. Remember to let her into your heart, then you can start to make it better. Hey Jude, don't be afraid, you are made to
Thank you, Al. Thank you. For one, and it doesn't happen often, I'm rendered speechless. I do not have enough words to thank you. And thank you for reminding us how to reopen our boxes and how to turn the sad songs into something better. Let's all try to take this as an action point from today's wonderful champion speech, and wish you all the best, Alpha, in your speaking career and your life. Thank you so much for being with us today. Thank you, Alpha.
Thank you so much for having me.
Moving on, what do we have next? Into the street, the piper stepped, smiling first a little smile, as if he knew what magic slept. Then, like a musical adept, to blow the pipe, his lips he wrinkled, and green and blue his sharp eyes twinkled, like a candle flame where salt is sprinkled. Yes, my friends, you guessed it right. It's from the Pied Piper of Hamelin, and our very own golfer, guitarist, and Pied Piper, Toastmaster Arvind Perumal, will be presenting a speech and a suspected surprise tonight. I call upon Arvind's speech evaluator for the day, Toastmaster Sudipto, to first read out the objectives of the speech.
Thank you, Madam Toastmaster, fellow Toastmaster, and guests. Very good evening. And good morning to Arvind and all our friends from EWS. It is a privilege. In fact, sometimes I become nervous to evaluate the speech of our most committed Toastmaster Arvind, who joins with us in the early morning of his time. Arvind, yes, you'll be delivering the second speech of level one today. And as part of the evaluation, I'll evaluate the three improvement areas which were identified during your earlier speech. Apparently, the number one is, you know, you encountered some amount of difficulty to make the right contact, the right eye contact. So I'll watch on that. The second one, that point of time, your hand gesture was limited, again, partially due to the fact that you presented it by sitting, okay?
And third one was we watched a little limited variety of vocal. So we'll try to watch on even on that point. And in the process, I'll check on your clarity, your storytelling capability, how you actually flow, and then how do you actually develop the interest among the people through your speech. So Arvind, your speech can be humorous, it can be informational, or you can follow any style of this one. And the time allotted for the speech is 5 to 7 minutes. So good luck, Arvind. Please come forward and present your speech.
Thank you, Toastmaster Sudipto. Toastmasters, please put your hands together for Arvind Perumal, Zen and the Art of Golfing, Life Lessons. Zen and the Art of Golfing, Life Lessons, Arvind Perumal.
Arvind, you're in mute.
Madam Toastmaster, fellow Toastmasters, friends and guests, a very good evening to you on this memorable occasion. I must say that it's an honor and a privilege to have the opportunity to speak today. Now, this topic that I've talked about in the past, but I chose to speak again, is because golf as I know it has so much to offer. So this speech is not about the game of golf per se, but it's rather about the lessons that it can teach us. Golf is a fascinating game at many different levels, and there's so much that one can talk about. But let me share a small part of it that I think you might find interesting. But first, the right attire is very, very important in golf. As they say, if you can't play, at least display. So on that note, let me at least set the display right. And now you can tell that I have been transformed into a golfer and I can therefore speak Zen-like about golf. Well, I think the hat is a must do, but let's see if it curtails my face. All right, now we're all set. So first things first, here. This is a golf club. It is the longest club in the bag. And this is a golf ball, which measures about 42.67 millimeters in diameter. Now, visualize this. 175 kilometers per hour. That's the speed with which this club travels when it makes contact with the ball, right here. Now think about this. This club traveling at 175 kilometers per hour, making contact with the ball on a surface area that is probably no more than 4 or 5 square inches, launching the ball in the direction you want it to go, at a speed of maybe 290 kilometers per hour. Can you imagine how many things must happen in the right sequence for that club to contact the ball at the right spot? There's a multitude of things that need to happen. And you have to worry about your hips, your shoulder turns, your wrist breaks, your club coming down the right plane, and most importantly, the club has to contact the ball perfectly perpendicular to its target in order for it to go straight. Now that's a lot of things that need to happen one after another sequentially for it to work. Now, is that really possible? Is that really possible to do it without thinking? As a matter of fact, it is. And it is actually a perfect opportunity to segue into Zen. So what is Zen? There are many definitions of Zen. Zen is a state of being where you're deeply aware of your own thoughts and your environment in an unattached manner. It is a state of mind that is not fixed by thought or emotion, and thus it's open to everything. Most of us have experienced this in one form or another, especially when we're working on some activities we like or accomplishing certain tasks. You know, some refer to it as a flow, and others maybe like stream of consciousness. Now, some of you probably are nodding your head in recognition going, yeah, yeah, I know that feeling. I know when I was working on something where I was so deeply concentrated and focused, and yet I was completely relaxed, and I was so into the task, and yet I was aware of everything that needed to be done for this task. So you can relate to that. But let me share with you a personal experience that might help and bring this out a little bit more. First, this goes back a few years, my early years of golfing. I remember a day when I was out golfing and everything was going wrong. Nothing was working out. I was hitting my ball left and right into the water, into the woods, and I was just completely just exhausted. I practically gave up. I stopped caring. And then what I did was, at one point, I said to myself, you know, this is just not working out. I had a part of me that said, hey, Arvin, come on, hit the ball harder, hold your club harder, swing faster. And this dialogue was killing me. So I finally gave up. And then when I give up and become indifferent, I actually put my hat backwards. And then I stepped up to the ball, and without a care in the world, boom, I hit it. I hit this ball perfectly. The sound was crisp and clean, and the ball flight, oh, you should have been there to see it. It was absolutely poetic, just beautiful. And then I asked myself, hey, what happened? What really took place here? You know, what really happened was that I stopped trying. I had a Zen moment. It was a satori of sorts, right? I had stopped forcing myself, and I just let go and did what I had to do. It just worked out perfectly. Now, let me ask you something. Have you ever experienced searching for something that you misplaced only to find it when you stopped looking for it? Exactly. That's exactly what I was talking about, that no mind concept. So friends, sometimes when you're in the midst of chaos, you have to take a step back and give your mind the room, the breathing space it needs to do its job. In life, as in golf, sometimes things go wrong. There are days when you feel off-centered, out of sync. But this is where trying harder only makes things more difficult. It aggravates and creates frustration and anxiety. So remind yourself to take a step back, detach yourself from the quest, and allow your mind the quiet space it needs to do its job. In closing, here's a quote from the founder of Red Bull that I think is apropos. As long as I can think clearly, I can think of alternatives. That said,
thank you.
I would like to dedicate this next 2 minutes to my club on our 600th anniversary. Now, you may wonder why I chose to do this when I should be thinking clearly, but I did not. So, all right. So what I thought was I would do this, right? Where I would basically thought I would just kind of do an intro first, right? Which was like, I thought maybe I'd write, do a intro on Sound of Silence. And I thought to myself, you know, Sound of Silence in a speech club? I'm not sure if that makes sense. Maybe something a little bit more uplifting, right? So, thought to myself, well, you know what, everybody's singing today, and you know, I've already embarrassed myself by proving that I'm not a guitarist. Why not I go the extra mile and prove that I'm not a singer either? So I decided to do this little piece by Bruce Springsteen's The Ghost of Tom Jones. I hope you like it.
Men walking along on railroad tracks, going someplace there's no going back. Highway patrol choppers coming up over the ridge. Hot soup on a campfire under the bridge. Shelter line stretching round the corner. Welcome to the new world order. Families sleeping in their cars in the southwest. Home, no job, no peace, no rest. Highway's alive tonight. Nobody's fooling nobody about where it goes. I'm sitting down here in the campfire light, searching for the ghost of Tom Jones.
Thank you.
Thank you, Arvind. An absolutely awesome speech aside, we have just had our first free golf lesson from a Zen master and a music maestro. Friends, can we ever outdo that? I think not. Let's give it up for the great man and his excellent entertainment today. Thank you so much, Arvind. Moving on. As Arvind said, we are all singing today, tonight, and no one's disallowed. So here goes. Lavender's blue, dilly dilly, lavender's green. When I am king, dilly dilly, you shall be queen. Who told you so, dilly dilly, who told you so? Was mine own heart, dilly dilly, that told me so. Friends, let's give it up for the kings of extempore speeches, the brave hearts of table topics to set our hearts fluttering. I invite the table topics master for tonight, Toastmaster Sushil Shaw.
Thank you, Madam Toastmaster. Madam Toastmaster, fellow Toastmaster and guest, good evening and happy new year. Let's start our today's table topic session. We all know that table topic sessions provide us the unique opportunity to practice our extempore speaking skills. But on this special edition of Toastmaster session, the table topic session will be a bit different. All the speeches today will be turncoat debate. So what is turncoat debate? Turncoat is a form of debate where the speaker literally debates on self. Means that the speaker starts by taking a stance, and after a particular interval of time, he switches the side. Means after a particular time duration, he starts speaking against it. Here the time interval and the frequency will be decided by me at random. I will call the speakers one by one, assign a topic to them. Once they will start at some, and with that, they will have to start speaking against the topic. This can be repeated twice or thrice. The allotted time is 2 minutes with a grace period of 30 seconds. So let's start by inviting our first braveheart. Our first braveheart is Indu Basu. I'll request Indu to unmute herself and come on the virtual stage. Indu, are you there?
Yes, thank you, Sushil.
Okay. Indu, your topic is men or women, who is more complicated? Men or women, who is more complicated? Indu Basu.
Good evening to all the gentlemen and ladies in Toastmasters Club. Gentlemen, I love you so. What I say now is with malice to no one, I do love you. But can you ever think of one group of people who are so emotionally bankrupt? Sometimes I wonder how they can be that way. You can't judge them. If I see a man sitting at a bar, I'm wondering whether he's celebrating or he's upset. Because if his wife ran away, he went to get a drink. His girlfriend came back, he went to get a drink. His kids are on drugs, he went to get a drink. His mother died. He went to get a drink. He was so happy. He got a promotion. He went to get a drink. His friend's getting married. He went to get a drink. What is this man doing in this bar? They are complicated. And as much as I like to share a drink at a bar with them, I'm still wondering what the emotion's all about. Then you take a man who tries to find his way. Never uses Google Map. Never. Never asks anyone for the road. No directions, they know it all. I was with a gentleman in this one car this one time, and we had to go to the supermarket, which was only 15 minutes away. We reached about 2.5 hours later. And then women are called complicated. No, it's the men. They're so complicated, Jesus. Now, if a woman says, oh, that's a nice car, a man will say, what make is it? What mileage? What model? Tailpipe? The engine's not that great. I can see the carburetor hanging out. If a woman says, wow, what an expensive car. Man says, BMW? No? Is it a Phantom? Bentley? If a woman says, it's a smooth car. A man says, what's the torque? What's the ground clearance? Oh, my God, what's the mileage? Ladies and gentlemen, very complicated lot. I tell you, that would be gentlemen. Again, I know some gentlemen who have dropped their gorgeous wives. And yet they're looking elsewhere. How come? Tell me how come. Now here there are these women who are driving themselves to bits, dieting, exercising, and the lovely gentlemen are still looking at the neighbor's wife. She's fat and ugly. But this is what it is. Men are complicated. They are. They really are. We try and tell ourselves men are the simplest things, but hey, even though we love them, they are complicated. Can you imagine a man through this pandemic? He had to wash the dishes. How many of you have heard it? We wash the dishes every day. We don't go telling people. But the men, they wash the dishes a few days and we all heard it. Sushil, I'm waiting for you, another man, to clap your hands. I'm tired of beating up men.
You can conclude, Indu.
Well, okay. In that case, let me just tell you, as complicated as they are, we still like them. But reality remains, men, women are not the only complicated things around. Try to make sense between all the blues of the world. If you just say blue, it doesn't work. It could be teal or it could be turquoise. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Indu, and excellent flip-flop. Okay, our next braveheart is Ranojay Chakravarti. I will ask Ranojay to unmute himself and come on virtual stage. Ranojay, are you there?
Yeah, am I audible right now?
Yes, clearly. Ranojay, you okay. Are audible. Okay, so Ranojay, your topic is smartphones makes us stupid. Agree or disagree? Smartphones makes us stupid. Agree or disagree, Ranojay?
Well, thank you, Sujil. And good evening to Toastmaster, fellow Toastmasters and guests, and also good morning to the friends from the US. Well, the phone may be smart, but just having it around make us stupid. Because even neuroscience research claims, or even shows also, that smartphones are making us stupid. Heavy reliance on smartphones to look up everything and getting the answer easily actually reduce our cognitive ability. Smartphone has a brain drain effect that significantly reduces people's intelligence and attention spans. Well, while we hold the idea that smartphone is only making us dumber, the opposite in fact might be true. Because on the positive side, smartphone could of course make us smarter if we use it smartly. I think mobile phones have made us the world like a global village. It is very handy to have a powerful computer too in your pockets. The smartphone actually gives us access to the full breadth and depth of human knowledge. Smartphone provides information the way we want it. It also helps to connect people instantly. But there is some problem also still with our overusage of, because overusage sometimes make us more dependent on the technology to do the things for us. That's why we are losing the ability to make our own magic mentally, socially, even politically also. And phone messages are and constant notifications are distracting and disruptive, such as studying, causing some rather distracting to reach our goals because of the forgottenness. Now, historically, technology has made us individually dumber or stupid and individually smarter, but collectively, possibly smarter. So it depends on you. Technology is only as good as how you use it, to control it or to be controlled by it. Thank you. Over to TM Sushil.
Thank you, Ranaja. That was an excellent speech. Our next braveheart is Devarun. I will invite Devarun to virtual stage. Devarun, unmute yourself.
Hello. Hi, Sushil.
Hi, Devarun. So, your topic is, the boss is always right. Agree or disagree? The boss is always right. Agree or disagree? Devarun.
Madam Toastmaster, fellow Toastmaster and guests. Toastmaster Sushil, you have given the topic, the boss is always right. Is it the topic? Is it a real topic to discuss? It is the axiom of life, right? Just like the sun rises in the east. Everyone knows boss is right and 100% right. In fact, we have two prejudices. One is we cannot challenge two persons, or two persons are always right. One is the Almighty God. And who is the second? Second is your boss. He is the second God. But we have rationals. We are logical people. We must follow an idea. Why should we follow a person blindly, right? What our civilization has taught us. We have to stick to our idea. We have to ethical. We have to cling to our professional ethics. So if your boss says something else, why to get rid of your idealism? You must cling. We must all cling to the idealism. And we must stand against the boss if he is wrong. Is that? But this is just a theory. At the end, the boss is the boss. He is always ahead. Okay, forget about your office. Any married man can share the experience about their home ministers, the boss. Can you challenge your home minister in your home? If someone says that he can challenge, but I really doubt, the home minister, your boss at home, is always right. Can you challenge your boss at office? After all, he will do your appraisals. He is always above you. He controls. So he is the boss. But at the end, we must conclude, it's up to you how you look at it. A glass, it's whether it's half filled or it's half empty. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you, Devarin. Excellent speech. So I have one topic left. Is there any volunteer for that?
No, we will conclude.
We conclude.
So friends, let's have a big round of applause for of all our brave hearts. Friends, have you ever used turncoat in your daily life? I use it a lot in both home and office. It has helped me many times, especially when my wife is yelling at me and I am not sure what she wants to say. Believe me, it will help you in these critical situations. where there is bombing on you and you are not sure what to say, I encourage all of you to use turncoats in your daily life. Thank you. Over to you, Madam Toastmaster.
What a session that was. What an amusing session, Table Topics Master Sushil. But what I suggest for you as well as for your dazzling array of debaters, I suggest you, strongly suggest rather, that you hire some bodyguards because you guys are all going to need them. What with maligning the bosses and wives and whatnot. Friends, moving on from that display, dazzling display, what we have next? Let's see. Two roads diverged in a yellow wood, and sorry, I could not travel both. And be one traveler, long I stood, and looked down one as far as I could, to where it bent in the undergrowth. I shall be telling this with a sigh, somewhere ages and ages hence. Two roads, friends, two roads diverged in a wood, and I took the one less traveled by, and that has made all the difference. Friends, the man who has made all the difference, the man who has chosen the road less traveled, the man who has made a mark in the realm of Toastmasters and our hearts, an entrepreneur, consultant, and trainer, director at Rooster Logic, co-founder at Smart Pani, the architect of Toastmasters' tremendous success in Nepal, the chief mentor of countless champions, the honorable parliamentarian of District 41 Toastmasters 2021, and the list goes on for Sumandai, our keynote speaker tonight. Toastmasters, it's my delight to present DTM Suman Sakya. DTM Suman Sakya, the art of rebound, the art of rebound, DTM Suman Sakya.
Greetings from Nepal. Congratulations to all the members, past and present, of Intera IT Toastmasters Club for celebrating 600th meeting. It is an amazing milestone. Wonderful. I think you should give yourself a huge round of applause. Amazing achievement this is. A journalist had asked Usain Bolt when he had won the second world championship of his 100 meter race, and after he came down from the podium, as to how do you feel when you become a world champion. Usain Bolt looked at the journalist and he said, I was the champion when I was at the podium and when the national anthem was played. For those few seconds or minutes, I was the world champion. But now I am the defending champion and I need to work harder to make sure that the next time I do my race, I still win. Amazingly said by Usain Bolt. Thank you for inviting me as a keynote speaker to this 600th meeting of your Toastmasters Club. I could see from the interactions that took place and the achievements that this club has achieved over the past 15 years, this club is an institution for District 41. With so many members and so much of achievement, you have been a mentor to so many clubs. The first corporate club in District 41, it says a lot. And especially having the support of the patron, Mr. Ashok Lahe, and senior members of the company, it just goes on to show that this organization and this club has achieved so much and it believes in what Toastmasters has to offer. But as we learn that every day brings forth a new battle, sometimes past success itself can become a barrier to progress. I had been discussing with Pinakida, as I fondly call him, of how running a Toastmasters club is not easy. You might have had a lot of successes, but like any game that you play, the next game you have to start afresh. You might have won many games before, be it in football or as Messi or Ronaldo, you might have scored many goals. But when you get into the field again, you have to start with a clean slate. And that has become a challenge for many clubs, including Inter, where you have members, but sometimes the attendance is low, and sometimes it is so difficult to find role players, and sometimes it is so difficult to even have an executive committee which functions properly with the responsibilities that is there. And I believe that any individual or a group or a company or an organization can bounce back, and we need to learn the art of rebound. As a member of Toastmasters Club that chartered in 2004, I started my journey as a Toastmaster then. Initially, it was such a challenge to conduct meetings. We had sometimes 6 people, sometimes 8 people, sometimes 10 people, and we had 20 people at one go. We thought that, wow, this was the best Toastmasters meeting in the entire world. We have had situations when the guest outnumbers the members itself, and we really didn't know what to do. But we kept on. We made sure that we focused on the evaluation of the speakers, and we provided the feedback that would help Toastmasters grow properly. And the focus on the quality gave amazing dividends. Over a period of time, Everest Toastmasters Club became the mother club for all Toastmasters Club in Nepal. Toastmasters Club, Everest Toastmasters, is not the oldest. The oldest is the Kathmandu Toastmasters Club, which is actually the oldest club now in District 41. We started in 1991. And we always said that Toastmasters was the best kept secret in town, because as a human being, you want to progress yourself, but you don't want to see others progress. And that what becomes the challenge when you start bringing people together and making sure that the club runs. The club can run when the members become selfless and create more leaders in the club as we move along. But when an individual becomes selfish, then it becomes a big challenge. So how do we take care of this challenge? Maybe the art of rebound can help us. Rebound is a word that is used in basketball. For those who know, it might be very easy that when you shoot a ball onto the ring, most of the time it does not go in and it rebounds, right? We have been taught that we must shoot the ball properly so that it goes inside the ring and you score points. But rebounding is an art form that needs to be learned, because if you can learn the art of rebounding, you can bounce back properly. Art of rebound is catching the ball and again making sure that you put that ball inside the ring, or on the defensive, you do not let your opponent get hold of the ball. This applies to Toastmasters as well as our lives as well, that we may fail in shooting the ball properly, right? And when the ball does fall down, we feel that, oh my goodness, we have not done justice. We have not done things properly. And we feel that we have not done good. But if we can gather the ball properly, or if we have failed, we pick ourselves up and come back. That is what rebound is all about. Big, strong, fearsome, and determined, few athletes have matched the fantastic abilities of Wilton and Chamberlain, popularly known as Wilt. At 7'1", he used to tower over others in basketball games. And he was the first person in the NBA history to score over 30,000 points in his career. Only six people have been able to match up to that 30,000 points in the entire history. He currently still holds 72 NBA records. Now you must be wondering, how did he score those points? And one of the records that he holds is that he has scored 23,924 points out of rebound. It is not the ball that goes in, but the ball comes out, he picks it up and puts that in. In the current era of players, the highest rebound scorer not even comes half of what he has scored. Isn't it obvious that we must learn as individuals to rebound effectively, especially when COVID-19 pandemic has hit us so hard? There has been times where things have not gone on properly, and it has been a story for most of our lives, including mine. When I lost my parents in 2003, 2004 and 2005 was the darkest years of my life. It was very challenging because I lost a lot of money in business, a business that I'd carefully grown in for a couple of years, and having employed 110 people, just crashed down to the ground. And I still remember that lonely walk from Darbar Magh, as we call it, a boulevard, to my home back, because I didn't have the money to pay for a taxi or a bus ride. It was a lonely walk back. I could have given up, but it took time, but I did bounce back. I did rebound. And I'm sure that there are stories like this all around. But how do you rebound? What could be possible tips or possible art that we could work on? The first, as we call it, is called the floor positioning. In basketball, when somebody hits the ball and you are trying to catch it, the rebound, you want to be in a position where you are near the ring, near the net, so that you are able to catch it. That is the basics of the art of rebound. Now in Toastmasters, this applies to how we understand the importance of public speaking and communication in our lives. Most of us feel that being a Toastmaster in a club, sometimes it is forced onto us, especially in a corporate club. I do not have the time. It is not my priority. I have too many other things to do. And on top of that, a Toastmasters meeting? Oh, I've been on Zoom the whole day. And again in the evening, I have to be there on one more session. No, this is not my priority. But world over, it has been seen that to achieve success, hard skills is not enough. We need soft skills. I do not know whether this example suits this audience or not, but one of the research that has been done by the Infosys Knowledge Institute that they have, this was done in September 2019, where they interviewed 1,000 senior executives around the world of their customers who had a turnover of over $1 billion. When they were asked, what is important that you see on a service provider or in their employees, you wouldn't be surprised to note that leadership and communication ranked very high. The only higher attribute was teamwork, 74%. Leadership was 70%, communication was 68%. And then came creative thinking, so on and so forth. So my friends, if you have been in Toastmasters Club and you have paid your dues, or dues have been paid somehow, and you have not given speeches, then you have not going up the ladder of success that is required, which is very, very important to achieve. Because without soft skills, especially communication and leadership, you do not go far. And what about the second art of rebound? The second art of rebound is that when the ball, when you're positioned and you want to catch the ball, you must leap up to the ring with all your force and all your might so that you're able to catch the ball. Now that requires learning of how to jump properly, how to make sure that you spring so effortlessly and so powerfully that you get to the ball ahead of others. Now, learning is a big challenge, especially after Malcolm Gladwell made it very, very popular in his book, Outliers, that if you want to become an expert, you need to invest 10,000 hours of your life in doing something. Now, 10,000 hours is a lot. And if you have done so, you do become an expert. Now, if you do a mental math of, say, if you want to invest an hour a day, in a year, you have 365 hours. In 10 years, you have 3,650 hours, which by calculation, which will mean that it'll take you over 2.5 decades to reach 10,000 hours. Or if you invest 8 hours a day, it will take you 5 years to become an expert. Now, this is a seed of misconception that has been sown in Toastmasters Club, that once you become a Toastmaster, you have to become an expert. You compare yourself with other senior people who give such eloquent speeches that you feel intimidated. You feel that, oh, this is not my cup of tea. I cannot do this. But recent research by Josh Hoffman has said that, no. We have understood it incorrectly. To become an expert, it takes 10,000 hours. But to become excellent, it requires less number of hours. To become very good, it requires less number of hours. To become good, it requires less number of hours. And going down, if you just want to learn a skill, it takes 20 hours. Just about 20 hours. That's about it. And if you're investing an hour and a half in your meetings, which means that in possibly 12 meetings or 13 meetings, you will be able to learn the craft of public speaking and leadership. And that is just over 3 months. Now, if you can invest that time and energy in learning public speaking through your club, you have learned the second art of rebound. Now, the third art of rebound is that you just do not leap, but once you leap, you are able to capture it, gather it, and hold it to yourself. Because there'll be opponents coming over and try to steal that ball from you. That requires grit and effort. Now, what is grit? If you have read the book by Angela Duckworth, she has clearly said that just because you have talent, you do not become successful. You need to multiply talent with effort. You have to keep going on and on and on. If you can do that, you become better. As we say in Toastmasters, you need practice. You need to put in that effort. And you fail multiple times. And in that book, she has also given an example of the New Yorker magazine editor, cartoon editor, whose name is Bob Mankoff, as to how he, as a child, he wanted to draw. He loved drawing. And he even went to music and art school. But once he went there, he became so intimidated by the wonderful work that the other artists did that he switched into philosophy and psychology. And for 3 years, he did not touch a drawing pencil or a drawing pen. But on the third year, he got hold of a book by Sid Hoff, by the name of Learning by Cartoon. And he got inspired and started drawing cartoons. And he used to send 27 cartoons for one figure to New Yorker magazine every time and was rejected. He even thought about giving up and joining the army. But then he said that, what can I do different? And everybody used to say that he was a very, very humorist. So he started to put humor into his cartoons. He started to do stand-up comedy also. And after some time, he left stand-up comedy and focused on just on humor cartoons. But that also got rejected. Over a period of time, his entire wall used to be filled with rejection slips from New Yorker magazine. But then, after being rejected for 2,000 times between 1974, his first cartoon appeared in 1997. And after that, it has become history. Do we have the grit? Do we persist? Do we put in that effort to make sure that we just do not just catch the ball, but we keep it to ourselves and then score a point? What I have learned from this is that you first need to have passion about something that you do. And if you are passionate about public speaking and leadership, Toastmasters is the place to go. The second part is that you must update your skills accordingly. And the third is to make sure that you are persistent about taking this effort to the long run, so that by grit, by passion, and by improving our skills, we learn the art of rebound. Some of you may be new to Toastmasters, and some of you have been there, done that, everything. If you are still thinking whether Toastmasters helps you or not, think again. You might change your life forever. As our patron has said, that he joined in 1977 because it showed him the path of how to move forward. It can be for you also. And for those of you who are an expert, who are excellence, like our speaker today, Toastmaster Arvind, who could play golf, sing, and play guitar alongside, please pick up 3 more people in your Toastmasters club and make sure they understand the art of rebound and make your life happy. Happy New Year to all of you.
Thank you, DTM Suman. What an interesting practical saga of rebound. It felt like we are playing basketball on a live court. Thanks for sharing your life experiences, the ups and downs, and tips for how to rebound. We have less time, but let's take up a few questions coming up in the chat right now. A very interesting question here from one of our very young Toastmaster, Pranita. She says that offensive is better than defensive. Offensive rebound and offensive force is better than defensive. DTM Suman, what do you feel?
As I've said, if you can play offensive, it is absolutely good. But in life, just being offensive really does not work out. We have seen today itself, or we have heard, that even with rebound, you can become a champion. That if you can combine your offensive with the rebound theory and put it into practice, you will be more successful than you are just being offensive.
Thank you. Thank you, DTM Suman. And coming up next, we have been part of Toastmasters for a while and we have given speeches and now it feels that we have reached a plateau. So should we continue? How do we know that we are there yet? Are we there yet? How do we know, DTM Suman?
In Toastmasters, it is very easy. We have been part of our legacy manuals where the manuals that we had gave us around 55 skill sets to learn. And in my lifetime as a Toastmaster, I possibly did maybe 8 manuals apart from the CC. Now, Pathways has been designed in a way in which it has identified over 300 skill sets that an individual can learn and master. I feel that even if you put in certain effort, this is almost a 5-decade long journey. Now it is up to you to understand and appreciate or feel whether you have learned enough or learning can continue. there can be instances where you feel that you have learned enough and you have plateaued, which means that you are in your comfort zone. Now, if you push yourself a little outside your comfort zone, you'll feel that there are so much more to learn in Toastmasters and continue the journey.
Thank you. My a plethora of questions coming in. I'm drowning in it. Next one coming up, DTM Suman. You are an entrepreneur, sir, and you hire employees. How high do you rank communication skills while interviewing a person for your company? Interesting question.
Just today, we were having a discussion with somebody who thought we could, he or she could be, I wouldn't take the name, could be part of our initiative. And the first thing automatic that pops up is, can the person articulate what he or she is thinking? Because if the person cannot articulate the thought processes, then it becomes very challenging for the person to express or explain anything and everything that is required. Maybe for a back-end office work that does not require so much of communication skills, that could, people may say that there could be an exception, but no. I strongly feel that if there is an individual who comes for an interview with a better communication skills, obviously the scales would tip on his or her favor.
Thank you, DTM Suman. And finally, I cannot resist asking Suman Dai a question since he's here with us tonight on this special occasion. We all know, Suman Dai, that you are the architect of Nepal's recent success in Toastmasters. You guys have swept the entire national field. All the awards go to you and you are the key architect. Please share at least one or two of your secrets. We do promise we'll not use them in the next upcoming competition.
This is a very difficult question to ask and answer as well. I say this difficult because I've been sharing what we have been doing throughout, and it is no secret. What we have tried to do is to portray that we work as one single team. And there are hierarchies, obviously, but every individual in the team are given responsibilities which they can fulfill. And we have worked in a team in a manner in which we have empowered the individuals to make sure that the journey is a very wonderful one, which is filled with fun. And we created certain milestones right at the beginning, even before the term started. And while the results might look good, my team members might be saying that I have pushed them beyond their own limits, and to make sure that as a division of 18 clubs, we doubled it to 36, just one club dropped off. So we added 17 clubs in one term. So it was because of the teamwork that was there and how they believe in the fact that we can achieve greater things if we work together.
Thank you, DTM Suman. You could not have been more articulate, and we will assure you that we carry your wonderful words of wisdom and we try to rebound whenever, hopefully we do not reach too many depths, but we'll try to rebound whenever we hit ground, and we will remember you as we go rising along the dizzy paths of our daily lives. Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together for DTM Suman.
Thank you very much. It's my honor.
As we progress in our journey tonight, Toastmasters, I'm now calling upon the General Evaluator, Toastmaster Debashish, to conduct the evaluation session.
Thank you very much, Madam Toastmaster, and very warm greetings to all the distinguished guest speakers, the distinguished guests, and all the fellow Toastmasters here. Now, it feels real good to play a role in this momentous evening and momentous meeting of our club today. So, something of that later. Let us get over with the main part of the module, that is the evaluation. I have with me some very competent colleagues and fellow Toastmasters. So, and thanks to them all. And I would first of all ask Toastmaster Sudip Topal to take this virtual stage and submit his evaluation for Arvind's speech. Sudipto, please.
Thank you. Good evening once again. And Arvind, a special good morning to you. And Arvind, I enjoyed your speech so much. I really do not know how to react. But you know, as evaluator, I'll have to do my job as well. Arvind, you had a very clear theme in your speech, that is, achieving a Zen moment is important to attain success in our life. That was very, very strong message came out from your speech. The other good points, whatever I have noted, first thing, that the storytelling was perfect. Even a person like me who does not know anything on the golf and perhaps who believed golf is like an, you know, another improvised version of playing childhood gilli danda game for the rich seniors. But even I would also could actually visualize the pain in your face when you are not successful. Point two, following the format, yes, I'll have to comment on your eye contact and the hand gestures following the comment from the earlier evaluator, so both the things were simply superb. And I liked your gesture, like, you know, the changing the attire at the beginning of your speech. I think that was the best moment to capture the eye of the audience. Your delivery speech of the speech was very assertive, inspiring, informative. And, you know, it has got a very subtle data points. What is the size of the golf club? What is the size of the ball, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. Fantastic, fantastic. But yes, there are few points which are actually coming to my mind. You know, you can take those things as an areas of improvement of your speech as you do more and more practice. Perhaps one point you could have included some humorous punches here and there. Vocal variety was an observation last time. Even this time also, you have used the various kinds of vocal varieties, but still the pitches could have been different. Let's say you have used, "Come Arvind, hit the ball harder." You could have said, "Come Arvind, hit the ball harder." Okay, so something like that. And the timing was a bit lengthier, including the music and the speech, but let the timer comment on that. So overall, the speech was extremely enjoyable. Arvind, in summary, I think you will think more and more how to connect with your audience using sometimes the touch of the humors and more like an attracting the audience even more and more. As such, your speech was anyway, it was one of the top class speech what you have witnessed in our Toastmaster Club so far. So congratulations, Arvind. You are successfully completing your project 2 with a very, very, very flying colors. Thank you. Over to the general evaluator.
Thank you very much, Sudipto. And now we will go over to the next evaluator, next role player. I would ask Toastmaster Pragya to kindly come up and give a report about the parliamentarian report. Pragya, please.
Thank you, Toastmaster Debashish. Good morning to some, good evening to others, and a happy New Year to everyone. The parliamentarian's report is as follows. The meeting started on time today. I'm happy to say that no cell phone rang during today's meeting. There were few instances when members left their seats while a speech was going on. Let's try to avoid this. Last but not the least, no one used any abusive or unparliamentarian language with respect to caste, creed, religion or gender. So the behavior of members was parliamentarian in nature. Well done, team. Over to you, Mr. General Evaluator. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Pragya. I would now ask Toastmaster Debraj Indro to come up and submit his report of the grammarian, please. Debraj.
Good evening, everyone, and good morning to the ones who are in the US. So as per my grammarian's quote, there has been some very good words and phrases that were used in the speeches. So I want to note some of the key phrases to you, like if you can't play, you display, multitude of things, malice to no one, cognitive ability, axiom of life, prejudice. So these are the very good words that we use in the in today's speeches. So over to you.
Thank you very much, Debraj. I would ask Toastmaster Bikram Bal to come up and give his report of the R counter. Bikram, please.
Thank you, General Evaluator Devasis, Madam Toastmaster, fellow Toastmasters, and guest. Good evening and Happy New Year. I shall present the R counter report, starting with Speaker Arvind. He uttered R only once during his speech, and there were no filler words or spaces. Excellent, Arvind. Now coming to Arvind Evaluator Sudipto. He used R for three times and filler word you know for three times. Next, coming to table topic speaker, coming to Indu Basu. She has not used R or ums. Neither she used any filler word or spaces. Thank you. Well done. Now coming to table topic speaker, Ranajay. He used R for two times and one filler words, R and for one time. Now coming to table topic speaker, Devarun. He used R for one time and filler words, okay, for one. Thank you. That's all from the R counter report.
Thank you, Bikram. And now I will ask our timer, Narendra Rathore, to please come up and submit his timer's report. Toastmaster Narendra, please.
Thank you, General Evaluator. Hello, everyone. Good evening and good morning. And a special greeting to our guests. Timer's report is as follows. Alpha Maya Shakya took 6 minutes 26 seconds. Arvind Perumal took 9 minutes 30 seconds. Rananjay Chakrabarti took 2 minutes 28 seconds. Indu Basu took 4 minutes 12 seconds. And Devarun Chatterjee took 1 minute 54 seconds. Suman Shakya took 20 minutes and 14 seconds. Sudipta Pal took 3 minutes and 23 seconds. That is the report from the timer's end. Thank you. Over to Mr. General Evaluator.
Thank you very much, Narendra. And I would ask you all to kindly give virtual applause to all the evaluators for their wonderful roles. And I would go over some of my comments now. Now, Toastmaster Sudipto has done the evaluation of Arvind's speech very, very well, as per the CRC mode and all that. And I would rather say Sudipto is a very seasoned Toastmaster, one of the leaders. He has done a befitting evaluation of the speech by Arvind. And about Arvind's speech, I would just tell Arvind that Arvind, you have, I would only use one adjective here, engrossing. It was so engaging, so engrossing. Second point was that this presentation was way beyond or above your last speech, as Sudipto mentioned. So it was real great. And Sushil's table topic themes were very different. So Sushil, very good job. The table topic speakers did wonderfully. However, let me just mention one of them, Indu Basu, because she, I thought she did something which was an ideal or model table topic impromptu speech, what it should be like. So really, Indu, it's great job. Our distinguished speaker and guest, Alpha. Alpha did a great speech, and it was a great speech. We had some takes from her as well, but I am feeling slightly embarrassed and guilty to say that I would say rather her, it was a great speech, but greater guitar and music. Great, Alpha. Then distinguished Toastmaster and giver of the keynote address, Suman, you were already great and gave us a wonderful, I would not say it was a speech. It was something sharing of your experiences, sharing of thoughts, which on this 600th evening of ours would give us encouragement, fuel to burn brighter, and all that kind of stuff. So great, and thank you so much, Suman. Lot of takes really, sir, from your keynote address. I would now come to the anchor and TMOD of the day, another distinguished Toastmaster, Swati De, my colleague. It will be a very platitudinous and cliche kind of thing to say, great job done, Swati. What Swati has done, without Swati's credit, the meeting has been star-studded. It's nothing Swati to do about it. What Swati did, Swati made it stellar. All were stars. How? She made the whole presentation musical, and she wove around the whole thing a synergic theme of music and poetry. So a great hand for Swati. It would be greatly amiss not to mention the silent worker behind the whole show who organized it practically single-handedly, although it was translated into action with a whole team who were all brilliant, who were all great, but I would must thank and congratulate our VP Education, distinguished Toastmaster Pinaki Das, for arranging this meeting, getting such great guest speakers and mobilizing the whole thing towards such a great enjoyment, which made me say, right, like McDonald said, I am loving it. Over to the Toastmaster, Swati De, please.
Thank you, Mr. General Evaluator. You are a kind man, and your kind and sweet words have really made our day or night, as you may like it. While we are moving towards the end, how can I end the meeting without calling upon one very important person who made our lives, especially for me and Pinaki, very, very difficult? We spent a lot of hours with this guy, and till date, believe me or not, this fellow's left InterIT, and still whenever I go to InterIT conferences, sorry, the Toastmaster conferences, I'm being asked, where is this guy gone? Where's the cat man? Where's the one who sniffs the bed covers? Where's that humorous champion? And Mr. Catman, Mr. Jumper on Unicorns, I'm sure you've guessed it, Mr. Gaurav Singh, can you please come up on stage once more? Let's have it once more, Gaurav Singh. Please come up and speak something so that we can see you. I know you're hiding around there somewhere. Come up on stage, please, Gaurav Singh. Hi. Have Gaurav Singh. Yes, oh my God, look at you.
I guess you can hear me just fine.
Is that just you or am I seeing double? You've become just double.
Oh, I have become double. Let's not go into that. Yeah, that's a whole thing.
And so, Mr. Gaurav Singh, after you've made our lives miserable, and I'm still answering people as to where you are and where we have hidden the champion. Mr. Gaurav Singh, friends, for all those who don't know him, he was our almost national champion. He was there to us. He's a world champion. And he's a great humorous speaker. And he's the best that we have. And we love you and we hate you, Gaurav. So tell us about your time in InterIT. InterIT and InterIT Toastmasters, and are you still into it? How, what's it done to your lives? It certainly made our lives miserable.
Yeah, I think, like, first of all, this was a great meeting. You know, it's been maybe 5 years since I attended the last meeting in this club. And I see the evolution of our club going forward. I see the growth. It's amazing. And it's morning here, so all this music is just like, I'm all ready for the day now. I'm already working, but I don't even feel like working. It's just great. It's awesome.
Where are you now? Where are you? What are you doing?
I am in Florida. It's always sunny in Florida.
Thank God. Thank God it's far off. You can't reach me. Okay. Quickly, what has Toastmasters done for you? Has it helped you?
Yeah, absolutely. I think one of the biggest things that you see in America is you have to advocate for yourself a lot. You have to go around and make sure that you're heard. People expect you to speak up, and it's very important for you to be heard. And I think that's a life skill that you require in any phase of your life. You know, you go to the doctor, if you don't tell the doctor, hey, it's paining me this much, you're not going to get the medical attention that you deserve. You know, it helps.
All the hours that we spent, haranguing with you, did that help you in any way? Do you have any good memories?
Absolutely. Oh my God. So I remember I was looking at the slide deck and there was one picture which was from Puri. By the way, the slide deck was just amazing. So many memories there. I remember going to Puri and taking part in the district finals for humor speech contest. That was the one where I was sniffing a cat for no good reason, really. and it was just a great time all around. And it was so educational to kind of see people from all sorts of aspects of life. You know, there were people from sales, people from ad agencies and stuff, all kind of showcasing different talents. It was so educational to just go and breathe that atmosphere. That rarefied air was so good. And I feel like that educated how I present myself and how I do things going forward.
So good to hear you, Gaurav. I can see a dog behind you, Tommy. I don't know if you have taken to sniffing dogs nowadays. We do.
No. Champions, but that's just my dog.
Go on, keep winning. And you made us very proud, buddy. And we miss you. Right? And
yeah,
whenever we need you to help us out with future championships. You know how we love championships. We love breeding champions, right?
Absolutely. Yeah, I remember. I am always willing to help, for sure.
Thank you.
It was a great meeting. Thank you for inviting me. This is an amazing experience for me.
Great, friends. So, it's late in the evening. She's wondering what clothes to wear. She puts on her makeup and brushes her long blonde hair. And then she asks me, do I look all right? And I say, yes, you look wonderful tonight. What a wonderful night, and how wonderful you all look tonight as we come to the end. Wait a minute. Did I say the end? No, pray, not the end. A new beginning, a new shining and bright beginning, looking wonderful tonight and looking ahead to a great year where we have tips for rebound, where we know how to open the Pandora's boxes and reach ahead. Do not fear. Achieve your best. Keep shining and blazing. Over to you, DTM Pinaki.
Thank you, Swati. Yes, it's late in the evening and you were truly wonderful tonight. So thank you for adroitly, poetically, inspirationally anchoring today's session. A true role model for anyone wanting to do the TMOD's role in Toastmasters. A big clap for all of you for happening, for making this program a success. I still see around, 40 plus people, 45 people as per the participant count. And at the peak, like we had around 74 people in today's meeting. And we had been discussing this, you know, last 3 or 4 days. And when I started this communication with DTM Suman Shakya a few days back, and we were discussing how many people will be there. I said, you know, in our club meetings, it is more like 15 people. And if we have a blast, it can go up to 70, 75 people. And that is what actually happened. So thank you all for the participation. Thank you, colleagues, all leaders of InterIIT. Ranjan, so early in the morning, thank you for being there and for encouraging us. All role players, kudos to you. And here is once again for your, you know, effort for the presentation. You guys were amazing today. And DTM Suman, Alpha, and all friends from Nepal, fantastic. Thank you. Gratitude. What a showcase by Alpha today. And what a keynote by DTM Suman. Suman, thy great takeaways, you talk about grit, passion, and the numbers which you put up, simply great. Let me also take this opportunity to recognize and acknowledge the presence of a few more district officers. So we had around 10 to 11 district officers who attended this meeting, whom we recognized earlier at the start. And I think like we had DTM Moon, Moon Pradhan, we had Ankit Goenka, and a few other people who also joined in. So I want to acknowledge your presence. Thank you very much for making our club's 600th edition special. To all other district officers and members from other clubs, thank you very much for turning up and encouraging us. Thanks to Ashok for all the encouragement, for supporting the club for the last 15 years. He's never said to anything that we ever wanted to do for the club. He sponsored everything. And to, you know, my partner in crime, so which is the executive committee of the club led by President Devashish, Sudipta, Sanjay, Devarun. So thank you very much for your support. I was carrying a lot of tension around the meeting today. A lot of work has gone on for the last, you know, 2 weeks or something, and you guys have just relieved that tension. Thank you all. We'll soon be sharing the video link for the meetings for the InterIIT folks also. We'll do that just after this meeting. And also on the district website, because we didn't actually have you know, too many or details of all people who are registered. So all the people who registered, the info that we have with us, we'll be sharing the link with you. Otherwise, we'll put it up on the InterIIT Toastmasters page. And of course, you know, there has been some late sharing by Suman Dai later on with some other people. So you could further share. So we'll be just too happy that others could also see this showcase meeting. Thank you, Swati, for keeping it tight. We are just 8 minutes late from what we had planned earlier. Thank you, everybody. So I would request the people to log out. Ashok, any closing words, if you want, you could say, because I will take some time to do the recording and the other stuff after people have left.
No, I think that Pinaki, you have done a wonderful job. I think everybody who participated, wonderful, everything. This is one of the best Toastmasters meeting I've done. You can see the emotion from the people, and people want to do the best, and it shows. Thanks, everybody. Everybody participated in this one. Wonderful thing. Learning experience for me. Okay, let's do the next 900 meeting, and then 1200 meeting, and all other stuff. Thanks very much.
Thank you, Ashok.